Is this where I pick? No, this is just reorganizing, which I don't... How do I get them to join my, like... I don't want to mess with this order, because they're in nice numerical order here, so I don't want to mess with it, but how do I... I just don't get it. Well, I can at least buy a new weapon for Machina, because I... Of course, I don't even know if the game's gonna force me to play as Ace once I go there, but I'm gonna roll the dice here and make a gamble. I'm gonna guess that Machina is going to be in the first mission, so I'm gonna buy a new weapon for Machina. That's what I'm doing. Can I... Okay, I'm not the fan that there's no, like, you can't see the weapon compared to the one you've equipped right now. I'm not a big fan of that. That's kind of annoying. Well, I will get the Argent. I'm gonna trust that this is better than our current weapons, so... We can't equip weapons in our regular... We have to do it in a save point. That's a bit, awkward. I might as well do it, I guess. I'm just gonna do it real quickly. Equip those new Argentic Rapiers on Machina there. It's got Bolt Rapiers. Yeah, that increases. By 2. Okay, so not a huge boost. So I guess the other weapons only increase by 2 as well, so not a big deal that, that I didn't buy weapons for someone. If it's only a 2-point difference, it's fine, it's fine. Alright, guys! High school hijinks are over, or military cadet hijinks, whatever you want to call them. Look at that freaking rocket ship over there. That's neat. It's time to freaking rumble. Sorry, I'm getting distracted by the people here. I shouldn't do that. I should get on with the mission.
Good luck.
Thanks, mate. That's really nice. Oh, well, I gotta talk to one more Koopa. Just look at his fanciful hat. A little chocobo told me you Class Zero kids only became cadets because some Koopa behind the scenes pulled some strings for you, Koopa. Hey, screw you, buddy. Okay, that's my least favorite. Thanks.
Good luck.
Thanks. That was easy. I didn't have to flash my card or anything. Oh, thank you. That's really cool that everyone's, like, we're cheering you on. Oh. There was one last, like, point here. Great. Okay, then.
Koopa!
This is your first sortie as Class Zero. Good luck, Koopa! You'll gain lots of experience in the field, but only if you participate in combat, Koopa. Oh, and remember, if things turn grim, don't be afraid to abort the mission, Koopa. Even if the operation ends in failure, the experience will stay with you, Koopa. Oh, that's neat. So cadets who participate in combat will receive experience points and level up. Those who remain in the reserve throughout a mission will not earn XP. However, some cadets perform better than others depending on circumstances. Prepare for anything by training all of your cadets evenly and utilize their unique strengths to gain the upper hand in battle. Adjust your squad formation at relic terminals mid-mission and deploy your reserves, or replay completed missions from missions on the title screen to train other cadets. Okay, that's a... I'm not a fan of that entirely, because... If there's no, like, residual experience for the other characters, I'm not a huge fan of, like, modern games either will give everyone experience equally just straight up, or, like, they'll get, like, some small percentage who aren't active. This is gonna force me to cycle my characters all the time, which I guess isn't a... I guess it's fine, because I was kind of planning on doing that anyway, trying to have a diverse teams all the time, but, it's a bit unfortunate that I can't... If for some reason I'm stuck playing as the same character for a long while, that'll just make me want to play as the same character all the time. Cadets not currently participating in combat remain on standby in the reserve. Those who stay in the reserve squad throughout a mission will not earn EXP or level up. Adjust your active squad formation at relic terminals. When one of your active members falls in battle, press up to replace him or her with the cadets from the reserve. Okay, that's important to remember. Losing all cadets will reserve from game over.
Certain squad formations grant active members primed status at the start of missions. Those cadets receive aura and trance status and take less damage. Boarding the mission will send the squad back to academia and allow them to keep all EXP earned. If all members die in battle, they will lose all EXP and start from the last save point. All HP and MP will be restored after each battle in the World of Orients. Immediately return to academia at any time by accessing the field menu. Now that I think is fine, I guess, so... Although I'm not sure... we weren't getting everything back when we were fighting in that place, were we? I don't remember. It's nice, I guess. Good luck out there! Oh, we had to go to the door. Alright. There we go! Oh my god, I'm scared, cuz... it's been so long since I've fought in... Oh, a world map! Unusual. Can we summon a chocobo right away? Do we get chocobo music? Yeah, it's a chocobo theme. Fantastic. There we go. Ah, good boy. Chocobo fled. Oh no! They're single use only, I didn't realize that! I would not have ridden a chocobo 5 feet if I had known. I thought if you use them for too long continuously, they leave. I didn't realize that. Well. There's a big pointy thing there. Don't I feel stupid now? Still playing the chocobo theme, even though I'm not riding one. I swear that sounded like chocobo theme. There's no way to save the game while outside. That's a weird feature. Alright! The cadet's first deployment! Let's do this. Alright, so now... oh, the game wants me to have Kater and Rem. We're not the reserves. So... hold on, just... I don't understand this. Oh, select active members. Oh, okay. Well, now I understand. Okay, so Kater and Rem are colored yellow for some reason. So maybe the game wants me to have those in the team. I'm not sure what that yellow color means, to be perfectly honest. Okay, well, I guess we'll take Kater and Rem. Actually, do I want to play as Kater? Now, why did I select everyone in the reserve? Why didn't this just auto have everything in the reserves? Why would... that's weird. Now, who do I want to play as is the big question. I think I'm taking... we got two level 8 characters. I could take one of those because they're like really low level, so I can try to keep everyone leveled up. Although it's a level 12 mission, so maybe I'm shooting myself in the foot if I do that? We'll give it a go. Now, maybe I'll just try Deuce, because it's so funny that she rides with a flute. I gotta try this for myself. We'll have Kater and Rem in the team. Because they had yellow color there. Select accept to receive backup from cadets and other comrades from academia on this mission. Sure. Right. Select abort mission from the field menu to abort the campaign. You will lose all items from Toma and SPP obtained, but retain EXP and
commencing maneuvers.
Oh, are those the bad guys already? What?
You're mine.
How do I fight with... oh my god, I can't believe it. So you have to hold down the button, just tapping. It's not an attack which goes off in a tap. You have to hold it down to shoot. Alright, good work, guys. That was really weird. I'm not gonna say... this is exactly as weird as I expected a person fighting with a flute to be like. Why are you guys glowing red? Is that because of that weird... Yumi Katsumaya has entered the fray. Okay.
Departing for duty.
Codename is... Who are you? What is going on? What the hell? Okay, fine. Look, just... follow me, guys. We'll head on with the mission, I guess. McTighe Midtown. Oh. Oh, I'm gonna have such trouble getting those, like... Getting, like, those, kill moments because... Because my attack is so slow. Oh, what's a concerto do? Oh, is it, like, hit several guys? Alright, that's cool. Oh my god, this is silly. Give me the machina. There we go. Alright, good. Good work, guys. Why is the support unit here? I don't want Yumi Katsuma. I want Katera to be here. Why did you... Ram has gone back to...
Alright, I'm here.
Who the hell are you? Why are you invincible? Okay, there is some sort of... There is some sort of gameplay feature going on now, which I don't understand, because these random people just replaced my characters. I'm not a fan of that, because I'd rather have the guys in my team in my team. I don't know what is going on. Why is there a letter symbol in the top? Coupo? The town's defensive have begun diversionary tactics, Coupo. While they distract the enemy, head west and circle around into the military base, Coupo. Alright, west. We got the... Incoming. Oh, this is a one of those SOs. I see, that's what it is.
Shoot them before they get closer!
Alright, we'll try that then. I guess. Just got to survive for... Come on. Oh, I think I'm buffing my character somehow with this concerto. Oh, 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 machine gun! That's bad. Well, this is... I don't know what to say. Machine gun! Can we maybe loop around? No, we can't. I'm really shocked that this is... Oh, a turret. Oh, now I see. Oh no, I'm almost dead. Two turrets. Just kill that one guy, please. Oh, I'm almost dead. Oh no. Great. Well, that was fun playing as Flute Girl there. Okay, well, I guess I'll play as Katera then. Because she's not in the party right now. So. These two random people showed up. Now this is more like it. Guns. I can deal with that. Auto turrets. That's a problem. Oh shit, I just realized Katera had a cure spell I could have used. Not Katera, Deuce had a cure spell I could have used. That is embarrassing. Come on, die, die, die. What's Elementillery do? Well, no chance to find out. We'll just have to do it in a moment. Oh, Rem's back in the team. Great, but this Noriko is still in the team. Crush the enemy's defense point with a frontal attack. Whoa! Ugh, ow.
Okay, then.
Okay, Noriyoko Inoue is now gone. Man, I don't know what's going on here because this SO that's on right now. And another new... I don't understand these support characters. This is so weird. Oh, we got an item at least. Oh. You must surrender. There we go. I think we won the SO though, because... I'm sorry, I'm so confused right now. If this was just us fighting these guys, I'd be fine, but my party members keep getting replaced by random dudes. And now I get another SO, these just keep coming all the time. Got some Tempoma at least.
Here to help.
Oh, jeez. He got bopped. Avoid taking damage. That's too hard for me. I'm not gonna lie. Phantoma, thank you. Okay, so now that I'm playing as Catur, suddenly everything's fine. Which actually, Catur's pretty cool, so I'm good with that. But goddamn, I should not have started playing as Deuce. That was so confusing. And I cannot get over why my party members keep getting replaced by these random people. I mean, is that what I turned on? And
go no further.
Oh.
Sniper team, get to your post.
Defeat two enemies when you're using your active leader. All right. Let's try elementillery. Freeze him. Oh. No, come on. Harvest the Phantoma, please. There we go. Oh god, I'm so low on time. I'm not gonna be able to kill the second guy. I shouldn't have selected this mission. I thought I could do it, but SO cancelled. Well, I'm at least not dead, so everything's fine. And we're doing pretty well, except now we're in Imperial Command. Oh no. Oh, he's looking this way. Let's take out these guys first. Ah, come on. If I could only get the kill shot on him. Oh! Those were missiles. No time for SOs, dammit. Oh! Oh! I saw that guy coming to hit Bayonet me. No, no, shit. Oh god. I need to cure myself. Come on, cure myself! I can't use cure. Why can't I use cure? What is this card here? I don't even know. Ugh! I saw you coming to Bayonet me. I'm stuck somewhere. Max charge! I don't know what. I think if I use elementillery, it charges up my gun? I don't know why I keep getting charges to my pistol sometimes. I don't know why I can't also cure myself. I would love it if I could cure myself, because I have the cure thing right there. Like, that would be fantastic if I could cure myself. Just gonna use a potion, of course. Oh, I know why, because I'm all out of MP. Apparently I have very low MP, so I'm just gonna have to beat this guy up the old-fashioned way. Ow, ow. Missiles! Stop chasing me, you Imperial scum! Oh, he's almost dead, too. I think I can do this. Oh my god. Oh! Guess I got a kill shot in. Let's get the Phantoma. Only 8 Phantoma from that? Oh well. And that's that, I guess. Alright, Catur was pretty fun, I'm not gonna lie. My grade wasn't so good. Got one SO completed, great. Special bounty, orderly shop news, remedy now available. Cool. Tactical vest. Neat. SPP both bulletin. Wizard's hat now available. Ooh. Oh, we got a mega elixir? Damn. I'm sorry, guys. I'm just so perplexed still by the gameplay here. It's so weird in some ways. Oh, well, we got this taken over. So what am I supposed to do now? We're here in Rubrum. Can I just mosey on back home, or do I have to go here? Enter McTighe. Am I gonna have to do the mission again? All right, new entry, the Rubicus. Oh, now it's just a village in our control again. All right, that's cool. And there's a shop right here. Sure, the town has started to rebuild, but that doesn't mean it's completely back on its feet just yet. Thankfully, the folks at Academia were kind enough to send some supplies. Do you need any, by the way? All right. Oh, we got all these fancy stuff. Oh, cool. I'm not gonna buy any of these right now, but they're neat, I'll give you that. Oh, we should also... got stuff, didn't we? Got the Ferric Ring, I saw that, that was a thing we got after winning a fight. Katera's now the highest level person in the party after. Okay, I'm gonna have Deuce in the party from now, but I'm not gonna play as her because that flute gameplay wasn't really my jam. I could play as Sank though. She's level 8, she's missing on levels. I bet I could mace up some bad guys. Playing as pistols though, that was super fun. I don't know, Katera's pretty cool. Just briefly having played as her. In fact, I'm gonna give you the Ferric Ring, because this is 20% increase in MP, while the Cupric Ring was only 10%, so there's no reason not to give it. Tactical Vest, who would I give that to? I don't know who to give that to, actually. Maybe Deuce, because she was getting hit a lot. Oh, she already has a Tactical Vest. No, she doesn't. I'm looking at that Ignis Primus there. I'll just replace the Ignis Primus with that. I don't know. Not a big deal. And since I'm crazy, I don't want to have these rolling around in my inventory. I'm just going to straight up sell these off. I might be making a mistake selling the Ignis Primus, but it increases fire magic by 2, reduces max MP by 10. Not a big deal. Can I sell off my old rapiers? I can. Good. They don't make a lot of cash, though. But and I didn't use Machina at all, so I guess... if I'm gonna be playing it that style, I should buy weapons for whoever is the lowest leveled guy in my team, so then I know that, I'm gonna be using them in the mission right away, so. Heh, now that I think about it. And I equipped Sank in my team because I guess I'm planning on playing as her next, because she's level 8, so I want to level her up on the next mission. She was that really kind of airheaded girl, wasn't she? Am I remembering that right? I don't know. I got a very loose grip on any of the characters in the first few episodes, if we're perfectly honest. Kupo? You all have been working so hard, Kupo. It brings a tear to my eye. Oh, something about 12 hours. Report back to Classroom Zero. There's some fascinating lectures, Kupo. I've got so much to tell you. I think you should be just fine on the upcoming level 13 mission, Kupo. Oh god, level 13, and I'm still level 8 here with a Sank. Oh no. Never heard of the cave northeast of Academia? Of course you haven't, newbie. That place is crawling with girls, though. So take some catnip along with you. Cave to the northwest with curls in them? Alright then. The curl was that weird panther creature from... I should remember this author's name. I think it was Vogd. I think one of his... Well, the story's name is Black Destroyer, is the sci-fi short story where the Curl appears. And for whatever reason, Final Fantasy keeps using the Curl as a enemy, even though I'm pretty sure there might be some copyright laws there. I don't know. I'm sure it would have been resolved by now if there were problems, so I'm gonna say it's all fine. I don't need to save right now, I just save back in McTighe. Oh, hey there, you gotta... So these are those time-advancing things, right? Well, talk to him anyway. I'm Enra from Class First. Yeah, that's right, THE Class First. Jealous? Sure. Isn't it funny how love just kind of smacks you right between the eyes? I mean, think about it. Could there be a worse time to get caught up in all that roses are red garbage than right in the middle of a war? Then again, maybe a little romance is exactly what we all need in a time like this. When you're in love, you've got someone to fight for, to make sure you make it out alive. But here I am, in love with the girl of my dreams, and that jerk's always blocking me out! They're not even dating or anything! Ah! Anyway, thanks for letting me get that off my chest. Good talk. Oh god, that took 2 hours to let him... We sat there for 2 hours listening to him yammer about the love of his life. Great. Well, there's a couple of exclamation points here. That's another 4 hours. He'll be left with 6. Why not?
Yeah?
The name's Azuma. You must be from the infamous Class Zero. What's the deal with you guys, anyway? I'll tell you what the deal is. I don't know what the deal is with us. Everybody's talking about you, saying you're the arch sorceress's little bits, and that you only got into academia because of her. Don't get me wrong, you guys were incredible back there during the liberation. But a lot of people are wondering why you guys could use magic when no one else could. You guys probably can't talk about that anyway. It must be tough having so many secrets. People don't like it when you've got too many secrets, though, so I'd watch your back. That Dr. Al-Rashi is a woman of mystery herself, and that rubs some folks the wrong way. I mean, she got into the consortium pretty quickly, and she has a lot of pull with the Chancellor. The people that don't think too fondly of her probably aren't too crazy about you guys, either. All I'm saying is, be careful that you don't get caught up in all their stupid power struggles. Okay. It's good talk, I guess. Lots of mysteries going around here in the village. I gotta talk to this lady as well, because look at her weird costume. Who is this? Actually, no, I'm not even sure if that is a lady. That might be a bit of an androgynous man. No, I'm pretty sure it's a girl.
If it's not any trouble, I would like to ask your assistance.
Yeah, it's a lady.
Oh, yes, ma'am? We are envoys for the Kingdom of Concordia. We must speak with the Chancellor.
Oh, that was the Blue Land, the Azure Dragon Land.
I'd like to know where we might find his office. We received directions, but the scenery impressed me so that I seem to have gotten us lost.
It is pretty cool here, isn't it?
The best way to get to the Chancellor's office is by going through that magic portal up ahead.
Oh my. It appears that we have taken quite the detour now, haven't we?
You seemed so confident. I was certain you knew where you were going.
Thank you for your help, young lady. May the path you follow be bright.
You have our gratitude.
It's not that big of a deal? We just... Okay. Alright, that was cool. Meeting those... Are you from our class?
Where is it?
Oh yeah, it's Deuce right there. Oh, the woman from before was from Concordia? Isn't that the country where only women hold positions of power? Oh, world building, guys. There you go. Becoming a Gito... No, it's Agito, isn't it? Becoming a Gito is a daunting task, so I'm here to provide an incentive, Kupo. I've got some presents to give you according to how much time you've spent in Orients. Class First didn't get to be the top class in academia without putting in plenty of effort, and I say hard work should be rewarded, so be sure to do your best, Kupo.
Kupo.
Do you have something to give me? Every Kupo's been calling you heroes after that circus act you call an operation, Kupo. I remember when academia had standards of greatness, Kupo. Oh my god, Class First. Oh, I so wish that Class First is gonna turn out that they're traitors being paid by Milites and we get to beat them up because, ooh, they make me mad. Well, here's a Kupo with another skit. Let's do it.
Well met, Class Zero. It is I, the Moogle of Class 8, Kupo. Might I steal a moment of your time?
Well, he's got an adorable hat, so I can't refuse that beret.
Though I don the garb of a common thief, the price I seek is one far nobler. Knowing tags, Kupo. You see, although you cadets entrust thy tags to academia before embarking on a new quest, our fair countrymen hold on to their tags until their dying breaths, Kupo. And unless your some kind soul takes it upon him or herself to retrieve these tags, what proof have we that those who die never lived once their memories vanish from our minds, Kupo? Oh, imagine the agony felt by families uncertain of their loved ones' whereabouts. Canst thou, in good conscience, allow our fallen citizens to simply be forgotten, Kupo? Nay, Kupo, I say it is our noble duty to retrieve these knowing tags and provide closure for the families of those who have fallen in the field. So prithee, in your travels, should you happen upon a knowing tag, I ask you to do the noble thing and retrieve it for me, Kupo.
Oh, freaking. I can imagine that took 2 hours talking to that dude, freaking that story of his life about knowing tags, but, we got a mega potion from it, which I'm going to guess is gonna heal our entire party. There we go. So, I'm pretty good with that. Where is it? Mega potion. Restores 50% of party's HP. Yeah. Awesome. That's a good find. What's our time? Okay, I'm pretty much done with the episode for today, so I'm just gonna close it off here. A weird game, I have to say, but... And... I'm seeing some problems with the whole plot. On the other hand, maybe some other people who aren't a fan of the more linear Final Fantasies or the more on-the-rails Final Fantasies can appreciate the customizable party style of this game. I can see also it's an interesting idea, definitely. So I definitely want to play this game. I'm going to say to completion. I don't know. For a while longer, definitely. It's a really fun game in some aspects. I like this hijinks here in the academia the most so far, but I'm sure once I get a better grip on the combat, I'll really get better at that, and I'll enjoy that more as well. I mean, that Kateur fight, where I fought the mech with Kateur, that actually went pretty well, didn't it? I really enjoyed that. Except, of course, for me mismanaging my MP and being very low on it and failing to cure myself. That was a bit of a problem, but yeah. Anyway, we'll go talk to Moglin and hear his fanciful lesson. Oh dear, that's one of those skits as well? Okay. Well, we got 4 hours, so it's fine. We'll go hear his skit and see what the next mission entails us, where I guess we're playing a Sank then, maybe? I'm not making promises, but it kind of looks like we'll do that in the next episode. So see you then. Bye, everybody!